to play it back down into the corner. Johansson there. Steals run down from behind. Hartman on it for Minnesota. Across for Zuccarello. Spurgeon joining the rush. Spurgeon and he scores! The Minnesota captain has the game's first goal just a minute 44 in.
Job of getting the puck out of their zone. Great play by Zuccarello to move the puck inside to Jared Spurgeon. You could hear Jared Spurgeon from the press box yelling through the neutral zone that he had all kinds of space in there. Pulls the puck from backhand to forehand and beats James Reimer right over the glove. And the captain strikes early here.
And now Zetterlund carries it through neutral ice. Flips it softly down into the wild zone. Middleton back there to pick it up for Minnesota. Comes out front, hurdle a shot. Blocked out front, Johansson had a chance. Fleury goes down. Now a drive by Nijhov, and that's walked into the corner. Nijhov with it again.
Six, 7 games, you might be paying attention a little more. This Wild team is so focused on their play and how they play, so.
Now Zuccarello got it to Hartman. Hurdle played it out to center. Zetterlund was tied up there by Goligoski. Gumba into the corner for Goligoski. Centered in, and a point blank chance for Eklund, knocked away by Fleury.
What they're doing down low in their own zone.
Couture centers and caught the post. Fleury with a pad save and the rebound. Another awkward deflect.
Yeah, they're gonna look at it for sure, but he tried to play that off his head and there's no, that did not go in. And Marc-Andre Fleury. Do you not get the impression that Marc-Andre Fleury just loves the action? He's in there jumping around all over the place. He's the type of goalie that he would love to get 30, 40, 50 shots a night.
Boldy looks, fires, missed the target. Hurdle about to jump back on the ice. Then it'll be 5-on-4. Boldy a shot, saved by Reimer. And he's able to hang on.
Yeah, this was the play earlier. And Matt Boldy skating directly into that puck because he was skating directly in. Some different looks. You know, you got to hope that the Wild would simplify their power play.
Eriksson Ek tried to walk out front and Reimer able to cover.
Ek down here doesn't go to look to set up the power play. He's got a lane to the front of the net.
Eklund leaves it in the corner for Hurdle. Hurdle worked out from behind the net. He was tied up by Spurgeon. Couldn't get much on the shot.
Typical Canadian, I guess.
Sturm plays it out to center. Breger, Sharks have numbers. Couture in and a save by Fleury. Johansson's pass out of the reach of Spurgeon. Here's a giveaway. Boldy's in. Saved by Reimer. Talked a lot about this stretch of great defense played by the Wild, and here they pay the price on the rebound on the power play. And the game is tied 1-1. Fleury made the first save, but Couture right there burying the rebound. I was just about to say, one of the things the Wild have done so well, this is the third chance for the Sharks halfway through the game, and they cash in.
Yeah, it was just a matter of time there. Tomas Hertl come up with a faceoff, was able to beat Freddie Gaudreau a couple times, and then Carlson, who's not afraid to shoot the puck on net.
Hartman intercepts, centering pass, deflected on goal by Steele. And Reimer somehow tracked this one off the pinball machine that was in front of the net.
During the summer, I mean, this guy takes great care of his body. The only way you do that is if you're a professional and you care and you take care of yourself, and it's very obvious he's doing that.
Sharks again have numbers. Johansson to Couture, and a sprawling save by Fleury.
Has been right near the top of the league, and it's been amazing what they've been able to do for such a long period of time.
Foligno to Johansson, rebound chance for Gaudreau, and he scores. The Wild cash in on the power play.
Find Johansson again. Great speed here, going to the net, is able to get that puck on net, and Reimer cannot control the rebound, and it pops right onto the blade of Freddie Gaudreau, and he makes no mistake there. And that is a really...
Wild got a goal less than 2 minutes into the game from Jared Spurgeon. They got one with less than 2 minutes to go in the second period from Freddie Gaudreau. And they lead 2-1 as we start the third here in San Jose. Sharks have given up 93 third period goals, most in the league. Wild by comparison, haven't given one up in the third in their last 8 games. Hear the score! Klingberg took the shot, it was tipped on the way in, and the Wild score 30 seconds in to add to the lead. It's now 3-1 Minnesota.
Message right off of the faceoff, getting it into the zone here. This wrist shot come in from Klingberg. It looked like Johansson got it first, and I don't know if Eriksson Ek got a piece of that on the way in. I do not believe he did. And what a big goal. Great deflection there by Johansson right at the top of the slot. And that one goes right into the net, and that's a big goal here to start the third period for this Wild team. There's your deflection right there. Does not hit Eriksson Ek. And this is the fourth power play tonight here for the San Jose Sharks squad.
Loose puck, hurry down the score. Hurdle got just enough of it to knock it across the line with Flurry down in the crease. And the second power play goal of the night for San Jose has the Sharks back within one.
Have come off of one face-offs. Again, just keeping it simple, getting the puck into the bumper to Logan Couture, and Tomas Hurdle, who's one of the stronger players in the National Hockey League, gets it inside there to Couture and is able to outmuscle Jared Spurgeon to get to that loose puck and just tap it over the goal line. Hurdle able to get his stick onto that puck right at the last moment. And
extra attacker time here for Minnesota. Klingberg gives to Zuccarello. Ahead for Hartman. Hartman fires. Pad save Reimer. Rebound, they score! Zuccarello hammers it by Reimer. And the Wild answer the San Jose power play goal. It's back to a 2-goal lead for Minnesota.
But Ryan Hartman, who's done this 4 or 5 times, just shooting from a wide angle, scored the other night on Hollebuck, trying to bank it off his pads, and does the exact same thing. And Reimer cannot control the rebound, and Zuccarello just pops in there. And
Carlson steps up to knock him off the puck. Barabanov in, drags it around Middleton, centered it on the backhand. Boldy intercepts. He'll take a backhand shot at the empty net and score! Matt Boldy with the empty net goal, and that should seal it for Minnesota. Extend their point streak to a dozen.
Was one. The Wild have played an amazing third period. The way that the Wild have played up late is exactly how they played here in the third period. Matt Boldy, who has struggled to score here over the last little while, missed an empty net about a week ago there. Makes no mistake there. And
the Wild start their stretch without Kirill Kaprizov with a 5-2 win in San Jose.
Yeah, the last half of the game for the Minnesota Wild was just, I mean, really outstanding. They skated really, really well.